Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. Welcome to my next episode, Day33 of my Let's Clash series. So in this episode, I want to start this episode by watching this 200 Barbarians on my base. So this guy is using 200 level 4 Barbarians to attack my base. He's going to attack in a very interesting manner, and of course the ending is going to be very interesting too, because my clan castle contains some wizards. So let's see how the wizard going to take care of the Barbarians. So the Barbarians, they're going to go down really quickly from the splash damage of the wizards, obviously, because the wizard, they deal a huge amount of damage at the same time they do splash damage. So now the wizards have taken out a lot of the Barbarians and now going ahead to take out the rest of the gang of the Barbarians. And of course, with just one giant over there just playing a fool, walking around, and of course, it won't be able to do a lot of damage because the giant is just too slow to try to do any damage to the Barbarians. But with the help of the wizards following up behind, the wizards is just going to take just one or two shots to take out the Barbarians, because the damage is just way too high for even the Barbarians to survive the damage. They even have higher damage than the level 1 wizard towers that is currently shooting on the Barbarians right now. So having level 6 wizards, they are really awesome. So this guy couldn't even take a lot of resources from my base. So going ahead with the next attack on this Tower 8, this Tower 8 is going to go down really quickly. I'm just going to deploy my troops in the V-shaped manner on the bottom, and then focusing on the top, going to deploy the V-shaped manner on the top too. So I didn't really want to focus on those gold mines because I was a little lazy to attack on this base. It was in the morning and I just wanted to get this raid quick and done easily. So I decided to drop my clan castle on the right side too, so I didn't want to waste too much time. So usually in the mornings, I usually just use my troops and deploy them really quickly. I don't want to spend too much time looking around and also deploy my troops slowly. So just getting the 57%, of course getting the loot, and just running out of the base. So going ahead with the next attack, this raid is going to be very easy because a lot of the gold, yeah, inside the gold mines. So definitely just going ahead to take out the gold mines. Not going to focus with the rest of the base because it's just going to waste all my troops. So some of you guys have been asking me, how do I maintain my trophies? How do I even do my raid? So this is basically just one of the way of how I do my raids. So the first one, as you can see, I won that raid, and then the next one I lost. So I only lose on those raids that are very easy to get the gold from. So like for example, this one, like you can see, the gold, they are all separated. So I might not be able to get the gold, but at the same time, I'll just try my luck to get a 50%. What I mean by I won't be able to get all the gold is because if you look at the gold storages, they're pretty full. So obviously I won't be able to get all the gold from the gold storages, but I did try my luck to go ahead to get a 50%, as I didn't want to lose the raid. So other than also attacking to try to win a raid, I will try to snipe town halls. Whenever there's any town hall available that's exposed on the outside, I'll definitely go for it to try to snipe it and scoring the win, and of course trying to maintain my trophy. So just one of the ways of how I maintain my trophies, because a lot of you guys have also been asking, how do I maintain my trophy? So now, as you can see, the clan castle has came out with a dragon inside. So the dragon is just gonna go down with just a few shots from my raged up wizards. So yeah, the dragon ain't too strong or whatsoever against a group of wizards, because the wizards, they are just too powerful against the dragon. So now the wizard is just gonna go ahead to try to take out the dark elixir storage, but a lot of the defenses are attacking the wizards, so it's gonna go down really quickly, the storage. So now going ahead to try to take out the town hall. The town hall might be able to go down, but just one or two shots from the mortar, the wizard couldn't withstand the damage and it got taken out. But not to worry, we didn't get the win for this raid, just 47%. But still, I'm going to go ahead with the next one with this 184,000 gold. I mean, in between my raids, I do snipe town halls just to maintain my trophies, and of course to get the bonus loot from all the bonus that I'm able to get from my being at Gold Leap. But this is basically my way of farming. I mean, I do not show you guys all those sniping of the town halls because it's just going to be plain too boring to just show you guys all those. But if you guys insist on seeing all those, it's basically I just drop like 4 or 5 archers, then after I just wait it out for roughly a few minutes, like maybe roughly around a minute and a half. Then after that, I'll just end the raid, of course winning the raid. So depending on the level of the town hall, of course, so it would actually depend on how long the troop will actually take to take down the town hall. So just going ahead with this raid now, as you can see, the gold mines, they're going to just be taken out, and of course I'm just going to end the raid, not going to waste too much troop and just using my clan castle. I try to use my clan castle a lot of the time because my clan castle is basically like a free army camp, so I do not have to wait for my troops to be cooked. I can just request for troops every 15 minutes because of the level of my clan, and then of course just getting the troop from my own account and also from my clan mates, that I do not have to use any of the elixir from my own account. So going ahead with this 240,000 gold on this Town Hall 8, just gonna go ahead to try to spread my troops out for this attack, because the base is probably gonna be one start, as I just want to go for the 1 star for this base because I do not want to drop all the way down to a low trophy leg, and then when I try to push my way up and of course trying to find those resources bases, it's going to be quite difficult. So it's really recommended for those of you who are able to win the attack. I mean, do not use like all your troops to try to win an attack. That's not going to be an efficient way of farming, but sometimes I do that too because it depends on what I'm doing. Like for example, if I know like in the next few minutes, like the next 4 to 5 minutes or even 10 minutes, I won't be free to actually do an attack, but I'm able to keep myself online by touching the screen, then obviously I'll just go ahead and try to win the attack by using all my troops. But if I know that I'm able to farm and continue farming for the next few minutes, then I'll just save a little bit of my troops and maybe not even use all the troops and just even lose the raid. So this is some little things that I do not talk about or show to you guys as to how I actually handle and manage my winning and losing raids. So just taking one look at this base, I know some of you guys will be saying that I'm just going to take out the gold mine and not going to go for the win, but you guys have to also take into consideration where is the town hall located. If the town hall is located at a place whereby it's easily accessible for your troops to try to take it out, then just go ahead and take it out. Definitely you don't want to keep losing and losing and losing a raid because it will just keep dropping your trophies, and then your trophies will be so low that it will be quite difficult to search for high loot raids. So I know some of you guys will be saying that now the matchmaking system has really changed and trophies doesn't really matter. I don't think that is right to say that trophies isn't a big part of the search right now, because I will feel that trophies is still important to determine whether you are able to search for a certain town hall level pretty fast, and also depends on how long you actually search for a town hall that is actually similar to yours. So take for example your town hall 10, you can't possibly drop to like 1,000 trophies to actually farm over there, because it might take quite a while to search for those town hall 9, town hall 8 for you to even attack. Don't talk about town hall 10s, I know there's not many town hall 10s as low bronze league or even in fact a silver league, because there were some people that actually tried to farm at around 400 or even 600 trophy range. It will not work for a town hall 10 definitely, but it will work for other town hall levels such as a town hall 5 or 6, because you will still be able to find those like town hall 4s, town hall 3 to even attack. But if you are a town hall 10, you will just keep clouding and searching over there at a lower trophy level, so it doesn't make sense for you to drop too low to actually search for it. So the trophies really still do matter, and of course you don't want to be in too high in trophies level 2, because you're gonna be matched with those really strong players, especially when you go on defense. Those people, they have really strong troops and they'll just go and wreck out your whole base and take out all your resources. That's why I try to maintain a roughly gold league, or in fact like the maximum will be in crystal league right now as a town hall 8. But once I reach the town hall 9, I'll be farming at around a crystal league, maybe at around 2200 trophy range, to try to take an advantage of the bonus. That's one. And of course trying to find all those town hall 9 and town hall 10s to attack. I mean, there are also town hall 10s and 9s in gold league, but then I would think that the loot ain't high, because first of all their base ain't that strong, and then maybe their gold mines and also their elixir collectors ain't that strong and high level too. So if you actually find that maybe their gold mines and also their elixir collectors are say level 6 or level 7, so if you try to loot them, the amount won't be that high. So now going back to my base, my barbarian has just completed its upgrade, getting it to level 5, which is really really good. I really like to increase the level of my barbarians and archers because they just increase the hit points and also the attack damage from them. So now going ahead to upgrade my minion to research it to level 2. Level 2 minion is definitely going to help me in farming a little bit. So as of now, I might be able to upgrade my dark elixir barrack soon, especially when now I only have like level 1 minion. As I mentioned previously, when I reach to like level 4 minions, then I'll start to use them. But I wanted to use them at level 1 just to show you guys at how it is still efficient enough to use them at level 1, especially when you're fighting against like cannons, mortar, in fact those kind of ground attacking expos. So you just have to drop like 1 or 2 minions, in fact just a level 1 minion, and they'll all be taken out. And of course those barbarian king that's all on the outside, you just have to drop the minions, and then the minions will just keep dropping some dark elixir on the barbarian king to take him out, and he won't be able to do anything. So I'm actually searching for a raid right now. So this is basically how I actually do my search, just searching and then looking for a base to definitely go for an attack. So if there's a town hall that's exposed, I'll definitely try to take it out. But I'm trying to go for a loot base right now, because I'm trying to get my gold up to more than 500,000. Currently it's at 495,000, depleting slowly, doing the search, minusing at 580 gold per search. The reason why I'm not spending all my gold to do the next upgrade is because I still want to have a little bit of gold so that I can have some gold to do some searches later on. So I'm trying to get it above to like 550 over 1000 gold. So this base has 82,000 gold available. I'm just going to go for it. I'm not going to search for very long to find those 300 over 1000 gold bases to attack, because I do not want my builder to idle too long, because I'm currently having an idle builder waiting for me to do an upgrade. So just got 500 over 1000 gold right now, 570 over 1000 already. So just going to defeat myself, and then of course just going to go back to my base to take a look at what I can do with the 574,000 gold that I have right now. So one idle builder, I do not want to waste too much time, so going ahead to upgrade the wall first with 74,000 gold left. So let's see what we can do about it. Going to remove the last obstacle, the trunk over there on the left side. So what I usually do is whenever I remove an obstacle, I'll go and search for a raid. I'll search usually around 3 to 4 searches, then I'll come back again to my base to remove an obstacle. So I do save some time, but also at the same time it's still a little bit stressful for myself. But it's just for this like a 1 minute or 2 minutes rushing for the goal period. Definitely not going to do this for like all the time. Just going to do this for this moment whereby my builder is idling. So going to go ahead to upgrade my gold storage. Definitely going to get more capacity out of it. So we will see how in the next few episodes. So currently I've completed 99 level 8 walls, and in the next episode I'm definitely going to get more than 100 level 8 walls completed. So going ahead to check my profile out with 341 attack wands already. And with 138 million gold stolen from my gold grab, I'm just a 12 million more away to getting to 150 million. So hopefully I'll be able to get like close to 200 or 250 million before I reach to Town Hall 9. So for those of you who are actually wondering and want to add me on GameCenter on the Apple iOS device, you can actually add me. My main account is You Should Know Who Am I. My second account is Time for Shady. And my third account, this account that I'm using, is Brandon COC91. So I do recommend those of you who want to add me just on my third account, which is the Brandon COC91, because my main account, You Should Know Who Am I, GameCenter for that account is full with 500 friends already added. So I can't add anyone else, and of course nobody can also add me for that account. So yeah, I'll be waiting for those who want to add me on Brandon COC91. And yeah, with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.